All right. Speaking of up the fuck set, take us home with a recent event and how you would handle it in the locker room pertaining to a certain former Seattle Seahawks now with a, you know, an incident off the field, if you will.
And we're not even going to say he's a former Seattle Seahawk. Have they released him?
Yeah. No, I mean, that happened earlier today.
He got released?
Yeah.
Good. So Chad Wheeler, right, was arrested on suspicion of felony domestic violence. Right, what happened was Chad Wheeler allegedly beat his girlfriend up for not bowing to him. Right, now for you viewers that don't know what the hell's going on, Chad Wheeler is a white man, and his girlfriend is an African American woman. So with everything that's going on in the world today, Mr. Wheeler has really fucked up. Just period, he's fucked up. I put it on Twitter, I don't condone a man hitting a woman in any circumstance. In this one, Benny, it just makes it more disgusting, right? Because of everything that's going on and a lot of things you see on Twitter, and just me being a black man and understanding that some men sickly do that because they want to be a dominant in the relationship, and they want to dominate a black woman, and they want to feel powerful, and they want to be able to say that this is my, basically my slave bitch. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is my, you know, this is my servant, right? This is their mindset, right? I saw something on Twitter that was just disgusting to me. It was a dude that is a proud boy, and he's married to a black woman. They have a little kid. But they have a picture in their house of him in full KKK cloak, right, and hood, carrying her through a river, right? As if to say he's rescuing her, right? Now, do what the fuck you want in life, reviewers, right? Be with who the fuck you want to be with, right? But when it comes to disrespect, not going to deal with it, right? So, again, I don't condone any man beating a woman up, slapping a woman, pushing and shoving, whatever, right? I just don't condone it. It's just not something that I'm going to say, okay, yeah, he was right, slapping the shit out of her. Nah, I've been in situations like that before, and I had to walk the fuck away. Like, do you want to? Yeah, right? Because that's human nature. You know what I'm saying? If you're getting abused, somebody hurting you or hitting you, punching you or whatever, woman, man, child, dog, right? Your natural reaction is to smack shit out the motherfucker, right? But this man beat this woman until she damn near died. Then, Benny, it was said in the report that he was surprised that she survived. Well, I guess you weren't as strong as you thought you were, Mr. Wheeler. Locker room situation, I mean, I beat the motherfucker ass, right? I'm just being completely honest. I couldn't see him. It would be on site. He couldn't show his face. And I'm pretty sure most organizations wouldn't even allow him to come back in the building after something like that happened, because they understand that, yeah, something's going to crack. So I just want justice to be served, which, you know, America seems to have a problem with that. Shame on you, ESPN. Shame on you, CNN. Shame on you, NBC. Shame on you, MSNBC, because nobody reported it. It was not news. It was not on Twitter, right? Twitter didn't report it. It wasn't on Twitter's whatever the fuck, hotline or hot topic or whatever. It wasn't on none of that. It wasn't all over, sprawled all over Instagram. I don't do Facebook. I don't see our Facebooks. I don't know. The media didn't crucify this man. Even there was never a mugshot, right? He got arrested. Where's the mugshot? I'm a black man. Shit.
Right.
That's what you got, right? That's what you got. And I tweeted it. I was like, America's not going to crucify him like they would a person of color. But right. I just want Mr. Wheeler to get what's coming to him, right? And if it be street justice, so be it. He don't deserve to live, right? He needs to get his ass beat to a bloody fucking pulp and like laid on the air bed. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, that's the type of shit that needs to happen to him, because he's a sick, disgusting human being. right? Point blank, period. There's no way around it. There's no argument. There's no compassion. There's no none of that shit, right? You literally beat a woman to death who is a fourth the size of you, nowhere near as strong as you. You're a professional athlete. And my son, I was with him earlier tonight, my oldest son, and he was talking to him about his girlfriend. Like, we were talking about the whole situation. And, like, he was just like, look at this motherfucker. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, imagine if he just goes crazy. Like, who the fuck gonna stop him? So you are putting your hands on someone who is nowhere near physically strong as you, aggressive as you, athletic as you, can't run from you, can't hurt you if she hits you, right? But you beat that woman until she damn near died. And then you were surprised that she didn't die, right?
Hey. Right. Which is a whole other level of, like, fucking sociopath. You're surprised evil. She evil. Didn't die?
Evil. Evil.
That's just,
like,
evil.
That's evil. That's evil. You deserve to die a slow, painful death. So, Mr. Wheeler, I pray to God that you, I don't know what to say. All right, I pray to God that you get what's coming to you. I'm just going to put it like that. Yeah. Hopefully the justice system will do right. Hopefully. But, I mean, I ain't going to hold my breath. So.
And that's why we want to talk about it, because that's really what it comes down to, right? If you're talking about the Ray Rices of the world, or the Kareem Hunts of the world, or the Tyreek Hills of the world, or the Alden Smiths of the world, they got crucified, and in certain situations, it didn't happen like they said it was going to happen. Run that back for past episodes, particularly right. As it relates to Alden Smith. Right. You're talking about, you know, someone who got their career taken away. Kareem Hunt, obviously, he was out of the league for a year. Now he's thriving with Cleveland. But right. As you said, the way the media portrays it, it's been noticeably different than how they portrayed this.
And this is an attack on a person. This ain't like, I mean, Ray Rice's situation was with his wife. And I said it on the podcast, like, what we saw was what Ray Rice and his wife do in private. It just happened to leak out in public, right? That looked completely normal. Like, when you watch it, when you watch the tape, that she wasn't nervous, she wasn't scared. Like, this is something
she was
that
used
she
to fighting with.
That she has done with him before. The situation with Kareem Hunt, he was attempting to take back something that was his, right? The girl got belligerent, you know what I'm saying? Again, he's a professional athlete. These are the motherfuckers you saw in the circle, in the round circle. These are gladiators, right? These are mammoth, unreal, superhuman beings. So, of course, it's going to look horrible, right?
Right.
But his reaction was based on her action.
Right. He didn't attack her with a vengeance and right. This whole thing, yeah.
No, this man, Wheeler, beat his girlfriend, someone who he was supposed to care about, right? Possibly love, because wow. I'm pretty sure they've been together for a while. He beat her to a pulp, bro. Yeah.
Next level. So fucked up.
That's evil, man.